This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. Book, My Double and How He Undid Me by Edward Everett Hale. My Double and How He Undid Me, 1822-1909. It is not often that I trouble the readers of the Atlantic Monthly. I should not trouble them now, but for the importunities of my wife, who feels to insist that a duty to society is unfulfilled, till I have told why I had to have a double and how he undid me. She is sure, she says, that intelligent persons cannot understand that pressure upon public servants, which alone drives any man into the employment of a double. And while I fear, she thinks, at the bottom of her heart, that my fortunes will never be remade, she has a faint hope that as another Rasselas, I may teach a lesson to future publics from which they may profit, though we die. Owing to the behavior of my double, or if you please, to that public pressure which compelled me to employ him, I have plenty of leisure to write this communication. I am, or rather was, a minister of the Sandemanian connection. I was settled in the active, wide-awake town of Naugwaudavik, on one of the finest water powers in Maine. We used to call it a western town in the heart of the civilization of New England. A charming place it was and is. A spirited, brave young parish had I, and it seemed as if we might have all the joy of eventful living to our heart's content. Alas, how little we knew on the day of my ordination, and in those halcyon moments of our first housekeeping. To be the confidential friend in 100 families in the town, cutting the social trifle, as my friend Halliburton says, from the top of the whipped syllabub to the bottom of the sponge cake, which is the foundation, to keep abreast of the thought of the age in one's study, and to do one's best on Sunday to interweave that thought with the active life of an active town, and to inspirit both, and make both infinite by glimpses of the eternal glory, seemed such an exquisite forelook into one's life. Enough to do, and all so real and so grand. If this vision could only have lasted. The truth is that this vision was not in itself a delusion, nor indeed half bright enough. If one could only have been left to do his own business, the vision would have accomplished itself and brought out new paraheliacal visions, each as bright as the original. The misery was and is, as we found out, I and Polly, before long, that, besides the vision, and besides the usual human and finite failures in life, such as breaking the old pitcher that came over in the Mayflower, and putting into the fire the alpenstock with which her father climbed Mont Blanc, besides these, I say, imitating the style of Robinson Crusoe, there were pitchforked in on us a great rowan heap of humbugs handed down from some unknown seed time, in which we were expected, and I chiefly, to fulfill certain public functions before the community, of the character of those fulfilled, by the third row of supernumeraries who stand behind the sepoys in the spectacle of the cataract of the Ganges. They were the duties, in a word, which one performs as member of one or another social class or subdivision, wholly distinct from what one does as a, by himself a, what invisible power put these functions on me, it would be very hard to tell. But such power there was and is. And I had not been at work a year before I found I was living two lives, one real and one merely functional, for two sets of people, one my parish, whom I loved, and the other a vague public for whom I did not care two straws. All this was in a vague notion, which everybody had and has, that this second life would eventually bring out some great results, unknown at present, to somebody somewhere. Crazed by this duality of life, I first read Dr. Wigan on the duality of the brain, hoping that I could train one side of my head to do these outside jobs, and the other to do my intimate and real duties. For Richard Greenough once told me that in studying for the statue of Franklin.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.